I like it. Okay. Let's, one thing that I would love to do, especially for somebody who's kind of new to the debugger, is I would love to spend just a couple of minutes on the basics. The step so I'm gonna make one real quick assumption, and actually, you know what? I'm not going to. I shouldn't do this. Let's start here. Let me ask this very basic question, and then we can sort of branch out. What's a breakpoint?
So a breakpoint, it's this little red icon here that we started at the beginning. Basically, what it lets you do is you can pick a line of code that you would like to inspect first. So, and then from there, if you hit run or F5 or whatever the equivalent is on whatever ID that you're using, breakpoints are pretty equivalent across most of the major ones, then your code will stop its execution at that given point. And then from there, you can choose to go line by line and inspect whatever you want, or you can choose to stay at that line and use whatever tools that you want in order to try to identify your problem. So let me refresh and I can go ahead and hit that breakpoint that I had set there again. That's sort of the gist of it.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, so it's like a stop. It's telling your code, stop at this given point and let the user decide where they want to go from there.
Right. Let me go take a look then at what the current state is. Let me explore a little bit.
Oh, that's fun. Gotta love errors.
Absolutely. Give that one more second.
So,
Yeah,
yeah.
there we go. I have hope.
And I have hope too. That's a good sign. That didn't happen before the pop-up. Yeah, but what's great about breakpoints is that once you get the basics down, there's so many different kinds of breakpoints that you can use to take it a step further. Like if you wanted to stop under a given condition, then you can do that, which is pretty sweet.
Chugga,
Oh,
chugga,
here we go.
chugga. There we go.
Yeah, slow and steady. Yeah, so you know that your breakpoint has been hit. And a lot of IDs, you'll get like a little arrow like this. It might be kind of hard to see, but there's this yellow execution arrow here. And this is the arrow that is letting you know which line is about to be executed next. And so, as I mentioned from here, my code is completely stopped. It's not doing anything besides existing at this given line. So, if I wanted to continue, then I have a couple options. So, the first one I can use is the step over tool. And step over just lets me go to the next line that's about to be executed. So in this case, it's the stream reader block here. And then from there, I can choose to step over again and go inside here. There are cases where you may want to step inside another method. And if you do that, then you can use step into. That's probably not going to work here because I have a setting that allows me to just ignore code that's not mine essentially turned on. So don't really care about that. But oh, I believe get base string for image is one that I own. So if I stepped into that, then it should take me to that method.
Okay.
So that's step into. And then let's say I can step into there and I could do this all day, could go on forever depending on what your code is doing. But if I wanted to step out of this method and return back to that line, then that's where step out can come into play and it will return me back to that line I was previously at. So that's
Okay.
kind of the basics. Yeah. So having setting brace basic breakpoints, you can set more than one if you want. You can have 50 if you want. And also the beauty about Visual Studio is that you can keep track of all your breakpoints in the breakpoints window down here. So if you do want to get breakpoint happy, just know that it's pretty easy to discover and deal with them as you want, as you will. And also, the perk about using multiple breakpoints, if that's something you want to do, in addition to something like run to click, is you can set a breakpoint, let's say at the end of this function, and then we'll hit continue, and it should take me to that next breakpoint. It'll go ahead and run everything else from that previous line that I was at up to that point.
Okay. And so that's a lot like that run to cursor, only this time
Yeah.
it's instead going to the next breakpoint.
Yep. Yeah, personally, I like to use run to click if I don't intend to use another a specific breakpoint for a very long time. Like if I want it to just be a one-time thing, then I'll use run to click. But if I intend to make a jump like this a lot of times, then might as well just set a breakpoint, but it's your call.
Okay.
Whatever floats your boat.